So this is the extra credit for the Unit 1 test. And the free response question we're going to solve today states that the movement of water through vascular plants is important for their survival. The first part of this question is to explain the mechanism of water movement through vascular plants during transpiration. Include a discussion of how anatomy of vascular plants and the properties of water contribute to this process. So first, here is a diagram of transpiration. Transpiration is the process of water movement through a plant and the evaporation from the leaves, stems, or flowers. Waters and fluids first get sucked in through the roots, and at each root there are little root hairs that kind of act as an extension and as a sponge to soak up all that water. And while water travels through the roots, the water leaves the plants as water vapor through the stomata. And the stomata of the leaves are like little holes that allow the plant to breathe. There are tiny openings that open and close to allow the intake of carbon dioxide and the release of oxygen and water vapor for photosynthesis. In order to understand how water moves up from the roots, up the stem and out of the stomata, we have to first learn about the properties of water. One unique property of water is the hydrogen bonds. Although bonds by themselves are weak, when there are multiple hydrogen bonds, those bonds become very strong. And these hydrogen bonds cause cohesion and adhesion. It was easy for me to get confused between the two, but a trick to remember is that cohesion, the co part, the prefix, is a synonym for together. So, while cohesion is the hydrogen bonds that cause water molecules to stick together, adhesion is when water sticks to the surface of other substances. And a combination of both creates capillary action. And water is able to move up the stems of plants against gravity due to the strength of adhesion pulling up the water molecules that stick together due to cohesion. Here's a photo of the root hairs. And here's a closer look. And this picture depicts the capillary action, and you can see the water and the cohesion adhesion between the molecules. Now the second part of the problem asks how gas exchange affects transpiration. And I talked about the stomata before, but what's important is that it's in charge of releasing carbon dioxide and water and then letting in the oxygen gas. And when the stomata is open, there is increased amount of transpiration because the gases can flow freely. But when it's closed, there is less transpiration since the gases cannot get in or as out as efficiently. The next part of the question is to describe two adaptations that affect the rate of transpiration in desert plants. A desert is characterized by its lack of rainfall, which is usually under 50 centimeters. And since water is necessary for plants to carry out photosynthesis, desert plants have to adapt to the environment to store as much water as possible and to let out at least water as possible. And most desert plants are succulents, which means they have parts of their plants that are more thick or fleshy to retain the water. And they also have thick cuticles, which is the top layer of the leaf. It's like a top layer of wax that covers the epidermis of the leaf. And since the cuticle is hydrophobic or repels water, it keeps the water in the leaf. And the roots of these plants are also specialized to take in as much water as possible. This small cactus has a large shallow system of roots for maximum water capture, and other plant roots may include deep tap roots to get underground to get all that well water at the bottom. And that's my video. So these are some examples of some succulents. Note how the leaves seem thicker and fleshier than regular plants. And here's the inside of one. And now these are the different roots of different cacti, and they're very thick and go very deep.